Hey, today I want to show you how you can use Microsoft Clipchamp to record your screen, then edit it all for free. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use Microsoft Clipchamp to record your screen on your computer and do some basic editing. Now, you can access Microsoft Clipchamp in a few different ways. I'm right now on a Windows 11 computer, and if I go to my search and just click on it, I can see that I have Microsoft Clipchamp installed on this computer. And if you have Windows 11, that's probably the case on yours. A lot of people overlook that you have access to this free video editor and screen capture. Now, the other ways you can edit it, if you're on a different operating system, you can go to this page, and I'll put the link down below, and then you can go ahead and try it for free. You just have to make a free account. If you're in your Microsoft 365 and go to All Apps, you can see that it's actually inside here. And whether I'm on my computer or online, it's virtually the same experience. It looks the same, operates the same. So I'm going to be just working from my computer, but no matter which way you access it, it's going to look the same. And I am using the free version of Microsoft Clipchamp. There's a few things that you get if you do the paid for. It would up it to 4K and it would save your files to the cloud. This way, you have to save your files to your computer that you're on, and it will work locally. But let's get started with how to use Clipchamp for screen capture. I have Microsoft Clipchamp open. You can see it looks the same as the one when I opened it from my browser. I have different videos saved from before down there that I could open up. I could go ahead and record myself by clicking on this. What I tend to do is go to create a new video, and you're going to see the option to record and create right here. Just a little bit about navigation. If I click on these, I can go back to the home. So then I could go back, and you can see how you can kind of move around. But under record and create, I'm going to be showing this one because this is going to capture myself with a camera and the screen. I can also just do just camera, just screen, or just audio. And I'm going to go screen here. And then you just have to pick what you want to record. So you can see here I am with the green screen behind me, and I'm going to show you how to remove the green screen. I can pick my camera. I'm going to use this one. I'm going to just keep it with the mic from the camera because I'm already using my mic and my screen recorder right now, which is Camtasia. I'm just going to go and hit record. Notice there's a 30-minute, it's limited to 30 minutes in this for screen recording. Now, what do you want? Do you want a specific window or do you want the entire screen? I have two monitors on my computer, so that's why you're seeing the two different things. In this demo, I'm just going to click on this PowerPoint that I have open and I'm going to hit share. So it's recording right now. I'm going to click on the PowerPoint and open it up. You can see I can just go through a few slides here, and I'm going to go and stop it down below.
So
I'll go back over to Clipchamp. There I am talking. It was recording me. I just stopped it. I could retake the recording now or save and edit. And just like that, it puts these two into my timeline here where I can start to edit it. Now, when you're editing, I'm just going to show you basic editing in here today. You can trim from either end. If you want to learn more about editing in Clipchamp, I'll put a full video about that where I go through all of this if you're new to editing, and I'll link that down below in the description. But if I go, I can trim by just hovering my mouse over the beginning. I could go to the back, and I could trim this way. Notice I could do each way. The other thing I can do, this playhead, I can move it to wherever I want. And this is going to be the split. So if I click split and I move this and I hit split again, I could take a chunk. So now I've highlighted both. I could move this over and I could nudge these together like that. So I could remove something in the middle. There's also the undo here as well. So if I hit undo a bunch of times, that cut is gone out of there. Now, the other thing you might want to do is you record once, you might want to go and record again. So I could go record and I'm just going to do a very quick 3-second, we'll say this desktop this time. So it's recording. We're going to let it go for 3-4 seconds and stop.
So it's recording.
We'll hit save and edit. And now I have these added to here. So now if I put them in, you can see I have this clip over here. And then I'm going to move this back. You can see kind of how I navigate and there's a gap in between them, but I can nudge them up. if I want to remove this screen in the background or even change where I am, I need to make sure that I ungroup the two, because right now these two are grouped together. If I right click, notice there's an ungroup. As soon as I hit ungroup, I'm going to click off and click back on again. Now, if I just click on this clip, I can move this all around. I can move my playhead over here to get the right spot so we can see where I am. I can size this. I can even crop. So I'm going to crop out so I don't get the edges, because I'm going to use the green screen effect in a moment. I'm going to hit the check mark. I could go over to the effects, and there's lots of different effects. I'm just going to show you the green screen. If I type green, here it is. I can just change the threshold to clean it up. You can kind of play with that, what works the best. I could move this around. I can still size this if I want. If I was just doing a little bit of a,
you can see, I can just
so there through. I am inside, kind of just like what I do with my videos with Camtasia. The other thing you might want to do, if I want to go and zoom up on a part of the screen, I can make a cut in the bottom one. And let's say I move the playhead, doesn't look, you won't notice any change. But as I go to this one now, let's say I grab the back and I want to zoom up. So it will go from this clip,
go through a few slides,
and it will zoom up to wherever I want. I can move these around. I want to point also out, you can add more things. So I could import from your my own computer. So if I had other videos, I could import it. I can import pictures and add it to the media, and I just have to drag it over. I could go to the content library. There's all these things like different shapes I could go ahead and add, and I can change the colors to these as well. You can just hit delete and they go back. We have certain effects. Now you're going to see wherever there's a diamond, that's a premium one. If you want to access more, you'd have to purchase that. But even if there is something like videos, you're going to find some free ones in here. Music, if I click on music, and we'll click on happy, and this one doesn't have the diamond, so I know it's free. I could click on that, I could drag it down into the timeline. And just like I showed you before, you can edit your audio. So if I click on this, I could hit the split, I could take this part, I could delete it from here. Now I've added a little bit of music to this. And also with, just like I showed you effects before, even if I click on this audio, notice I can adjust the volume to this. We can even fade in and fade out with the when the music ends up. And we even have different things from speed and captions and all these different things you can use inside Clipchamp, all for free. When you're all done, what you can do is export it. I like to give a title on this, so let's just call this demo. And I'm going to go and just drop down. Notice that for 4K, you would need to have a paid for version, but I don't have that. So I'm going to hit 1080p. It's called demo. I could change the name. It's automatically downloading now. I can click save to the computer and I can change where I want to save it. It shows the length, the size. If I go ahead, I can open it from here. So I could open the Explorer or open the file. I'll click on it here.
So it's recording right now.
So there is that little video capture of the screen and some basic editing. But do take a look at the other video that I showed that will be coming out, how to use Clipchamp.